Hi, you are all welcome back to AlgebraReal Math Solutions. Today we want to prove whether or not root 2 and root 3 are they rational numbers or irrational numbers. We saw in our earlier discussion that they are irrational numbers, but how can we be sure there must be a way? So follow me to the board, not anywhere else. We are going to prove that. And it's very, very, very interesting. So let's start with root 3. We all know root 3 is an irrational number, but how can we determine that? First, let's assume that root 3 is rational. And we said all rational numbers can be written in the form A over B, where B is not equal to 0. And A over B is a fraction. A is a real number, B is a real number, and they are in their what? Lowest term. They cannot be further simplified. So to begin with, let's try squaring both sides so that we can do away with the square root and see what happens. When we square both sides of the equation, I'm going to get 3 being equal to a squared over b squared, as our algebra tells us. Now, let's cross multiply to get a linear expression. We are going to get 3b squared equals a squared. Now, here we want to see whether B and A are even numbers or odd numbers. How can we determine that? Now, let's look at the left hand side of the equation. We can see 3B squared. One thing we can note about the number 3 is that it is odd. But when you multiply 3 by an odd number, the product it gets will be odd. The same way, when you multiply 3 by an even number, the product will be even. So here we can't tell if B squared is even or odd. So we have to assume or we have to choose one. Okay, now let's take it as if B squared is odd. If B squared is odd, it follows that B will also be odd, because any odd number squared, you get what? An odd number. And any even number squared, you get an even number. So if you are assuming that B squared is odd, it definitely comes that B also was odd. And since the entire left-hand side is equal to the entire right-hand side, it also follows that A squared is also odd. If A squared is odd, A is also definitely what? Odd. So if we are saying B squared should be odd, B, A squared and A are all what? Odd. So we have to place an expression within this equation to change the outlook so that we can work more easily with that. Okay, now let's find an expression for A and B. Now we know 2 multiplied by any number is even, plus 1 will make it odd. So let's assume A will be 2x plus 1, so that we know that this expression is actually what? Odd. And let's give B to 2y plus 1, which makes it also odd. So we are going to replace these two values into our beloved equation here, 3b squared equals a squared, which implies 3 2y plus 1 all squared equals 2x plus 1 all squared. Expanding the brackets, we are going to get 12y squared plus 12y plus 3 being equal to 4x squared plus 4 8 plus 4x plus another 4. Okay, so our expansion is done. No, 1 squared is still 1, so we have 1 here. Now, we can see that majority of the factors or coefficients are divisible by 2. So we want to send this positive 1 here to be minus so that it reduces the 3 to a 2. Now we are going to have 12y squared plus 12y plus 2 equals 4x squared plus 4x. Now we can divide 2 by 2 to reduce the magnitude of the equation. So we have 6y squared plus 6y plus 1 equals 2x squared plus 2x. Now we are done with our simplification. We want to see if the left hand side is actually equal to the right hand side. How do we get to know? We know 6 is an even number, and 6 multiplied by any number will give you an even answer. 6 by this one will give you an even answer. Even number plus even number will give you an even answer, plus 1 will give you an odd answer. So the entire expression here is odd. But we need to equal to this side. We know 2 by any expression is even. 2 by this expression also even. And when you add 2 even numbers, you are going to get what? An even answer. There is no way an odd answer can be equal to what? An even answer. So this shows us that root 3 is not rational. If it's not rational, then it means it is what? An irrational number. So I hope the proof is clear. You can go through it. We first square both sides. We make it a linear equation. We test for this being odd or even. And because of this theory, we can get it being odd or even. So we chose odd. And we place 2x plus 1, which makes a odd, 2y plus 1, which makes b odd, into the equation. And we found out they couldn't give us the same answer we needed. So it proved that the 3 is what actually an irrational number.